He's got stored up for that time, and I sure do think He owns that. I don't want to die. There ain't a part of me that wants to die. I ain't ready to leave here just yet. I've got a lot of things that I'd still like to do. I believe the Lord has a lot of things He'd still like for me to do. But, you know, if it happened, if we got in some sort of a wreck or some sort of sickness befell me, I know that I'm taken care of. And like I said, you know, I don't want to leave here, but I know that when it comes time to cross that river, He's going to be right there with me.
Take them off our mind. We travel through the Thank you. peace and joy are now so real they can't be hidden. Within the boundaries of this same old frame, the book of life is now gone. A brand new picture where Jesus took his blood and wrote my name. not call me,
Lord,
and I wouldn't be ready to die. Now if I was a sinner,
Lord,
I'll tell you what I would do.
Would you
I'd lay aside my sinful ways and work on a building too.
Good Lord, now.
Oh, what weeping and wailing,
Lord, when
the laws were told of their fate, they cried to the rocks and the mountains. That the nations had gathered to the judgment before the white throne. From the throne came a bright shining angel,
Lord,
that stood on the land and sea, and swore with his hand raised to heaven,
Lord,
that time no longer could be.
Lord, now.
Oh, what a weeping and a wailing,
Lord,
when the laws were told of their fate, they cried to the rocks and the mountains. Sorrows into heaven forever.
Oh,
God wiped all the tears from their eyes. The gambler was there with the drunkard, and the man who sold them their dream. The people who issued them their license,
oh,
together in hell did sing.
Good Lord, now.
Oh, what a weeping and a wailing,
Lord,
when the laws were told of their fame. They cried to the rocks and the mountains. Oh, what a weeping and a wailing,
Lord,
when the laws were told of their fame. They cried to the rocks and the mountains.
Oh, the mountain.
Lord, they prayed their prayer was too late. Late.
Oh.
this. It's been a while since we've done this song. We all, six of us, work full time, so it's hard for us to get together and practice as much as we really need to, want to. But we practiced a little last night, for quite a while last night, and we realized we had about 45 minutes worth of material before last night. So we kind of threw together some of the old stuff that we used to do as haulers of the way, and we hope that we're not too rusty, and we might get through this one. We might not, but oh well, the Lord will bless us. And I feel like we need to sing it. It's a good song. It's just talking about being humble, and the title of it is called "I'm Asking You." I'll let it speak for itself. But I really like the band Blue Highway. I'm sure some of you have heard of them. And Sean Lane wrote this song. He's always been kind of an inspiration to me. And, I've kind of followed him ever since I was big enough to turn on radio. Really, Blue Highway they started in 1996, and I was 3 years old in 1996. So my dad listened to them, and so I listened to them, and I've listened to them for 24 years, or well, 21 years. But we'll do this song, and hopefully we'll get through it.
Jesus, I am thankful. To heal the heart and clear the
bluegrass anyway. I just changed these strings today, so of course they're not going to play. This banjo gets stage fright.
Worse than me.
Yeah. This banjo gets real nervous when a bunch of people start doing that.
It's kind of funny hearing the, well not funny, but hearing Aaron talk a second ago. And I got to meet John, I don't know, probably about an hour and 15 minutes ago or a little more. I asked him, man, you know, you gonna do some preaching tonight, brother? You got something to talk about or somebody else gonna come speak? I said, well, you know, you guys are kind of late event. We're hoping to do music and have good singing. And in the back of my head, I was thinking, man, I hope the Lord leads him to talk tonight. You know, I'd really like to hear him say something. And the last thing we said about him speaking was, let's do whatever the Spirit leads us to do. And I guess that right there was it. I was like, you know what? That's not what I was expecting, but that right there satisfied my thirst.
I'm so glad since Jesus changed.